Things represent little mini rivers that flow off into the ocean. This is like really alluvial soil. This is really, really a rich area. So this was prime real estate. So everybody was trying to get there. You feel what I'm saying? Everybody was trying to get there. But what happened was, because all of Ethiopia was from Algeria to what they call Egypt, and from Egypt to what they call the Sudan. All of this was Ethiopia. So there were black people everywhere. But the indigenous people said, hey, so many people crowding up over here, causing so many problems. Menace came from Thebes and said, let me go up here and settle these people down. Try to teach them how to be civilized. Because we got all these different races and nationalities and everything coming together here, trying to benefit off of the soil. So let me go in there and civilize them. Let me show them how to live.
So who tried to show them how to live?
Menace.
And that was a relative,
that was a man from the south, from the Sudan. Now, when, this is just a little side note, when the speckles of lighter hues started showing up in Lower Kim, and then Menace unified the two lands, there were some people in the south that didn't agree with that move. Some people in the south really, really wanted to just take them out from the beginning. They were called Nubian. The reason why they were called Nubian is because they wanted to preserve the blackness of their skin. So this is what I like to refer to as the first races. The world's first races really was Nubians, because they said, forget that. We want to keep it, you know, separate. So all of the wars against Nubia went from Lower Kim to Upper Kim. Now, they will try to tell you in those encyclopedias, real quick, I'm getting off, but they'll try to tell you in those encyclopedias that there were so many expeditions into Nubia. And they'll tell you it was the fourth dynasty, the fifth dynasty, the sixth dynasty, the old kingdom. Early on, there were expeditions into Nubia. But what they're not explaining to you is that Memphis was ran by a man from Nubia. You understand what I'm saying? Before they called it Nubia. Because they also give you that. They say, well, Nubia was formed in such and such time. You understand what I'm saying? To make it seem like Nubia is something new. But in actuality, what it was all these black people was down here. Menace and his crew came up here, and the rest of the black people said, nah, we Nubian, and we're going to stay Nubian. So that's a political difference. So rather, whether they were black, white, or otherwise, it's a political difference. So yeah, there was expeditions, but it was actually black-on-black expeditions. You understand what I'm saying? Okay, so anyway, from 3100 BC to 1633 BC, the Hyksos, or the foreign rulers, were allowed to live comfortably in Lower Kim. Okay, now, again, the one thing that we have is the fact that Narmer was from the south, the fact that all of the black people get pushed all the way to the south, that they stay in the south. Here's the other indication that we have that this was, that the indigenous people here were black people. Here's the other indication that we have. 1600 BC, 33 years later, okay, our next bullet, 1600 BC, can you shake that for me, bro? There we go. This is the Valley of the Kings. This is what I'm putting in parentheses here. The Valley of the Kings. Okay? It's, yeah. 1600 BC, the Valley of the Kings. Now, obviously, 1633 is the official, our official start date for the expulsion of the Hyksos when they were expelled. And please believe me, encyclopedic. I'm using encyclopedic terms. The unification of two lands, encyclopedic. The expulsion of the Hyksos, encyclopedic. This is encyclopedic terms. Please look it up. Please go to Encyclopedia Britannica. It will blow you away. If you're like, they didn't really see this. But, okay, 33 years after the official date. Now, I'm going to say you got about 33 years of either warring with the Hyksos, still trying to get back in, dealing with the diplomacy from the indigenous people that's still there. You got a few years of, you know, 30 years. 30 years is long enough for one king to reign. So 33 years is a real short amount of time. It's basically the point that I'm making. But really quickly, after the Hyksos, the foreign rulers, were expelled, the Valley of the Kings was formed, and thieves. Okay? Back in the South. Now, I'm going to give you Chancellor Williams' assertion on this. What Chancellor Williams says is, it was necessary to form the Valley of the Kings to preserve the Nubian legacy, to preserve the black legacy of Egypt. The Valley of the Kings was necessary. True indeed, the Valley of the Kings started in around the 16th dynasty. Okay, around the 16th century, which is, if you date Egypt all the way back to 10,500 BC, 1600 BC is you know, a good little ways away from there. Okay, so it sounds fairly new. Okay, but think about if you had, how many years from 3100 to 1633?
1467.
1467 years of these foreign people who were not from your land. You gave them kingships, you called them pharaohs, everything. And you've learned that they're deceptive. You've learned that they're attempting to cover your history with their own. That they're attempting to make themselves you. So what do? You bury every essence of your culture in the essence of where you come from, in the South. You go back to the South, you go back to Thebes, and you bury your kings. And you say, this is the Valley of the True Kings. Okay? So then, this is where you have the conflict. Chancellor Williams will tell you, you know, Mentuhotep III was the king of the 13th dynasty. Okay? They're going to tell you Tutankhamun was the king of the 13th dynasty. Why? Because Mentuhotep was holding it down here, and Tutankhamun was up here, claiming to be the king. So they're going to say, oh, well, he was a king. There's a bust of him. There's a tomb for him. It's during that time he was the king. You understand what I'm saying? When the real king was down here. So the Valley of the Kings was formed in 1600 BC, right after they expelled the Hyksos. Now, if I'm a foreign ruler, okay, and I want to preserve my legacy, wouldn't I put it where I ruled? These people ruled in Lower Kim. There's no temples of the ancient kings in Lower Kim. They're all down here. Strange enough. Okay, again, that's another proof of the indigenous nature of black peoples to Egypt, what they call Egypt, okay? Okay, and finally, our last thing that we're going to deal with, which is going to bring us, it's going to bring us right up to speed with our current lesson, which is the elements. We are going to get to the elements, okay? 334 BC, again, you know, that's contested, but 334 BC is Alexandria. So, from 1600 BC to 334 BC, 1600 minus 334, what's that?
1266.
Sure?
Yeah.
Okay. I might have done the math wrong on it. Y'all might have to correct me on the quiz. 1266?
Yeah.
Okay, so 1266 years later, after the Valley of the Kings has been formed, after the Hyksos have been expelled, you've had Israel, Jerusalem, and all of that being built, okay? How many, 1266 years later?
Yeah.
Hmm?
So, yeah,
1266 years later,
hello.
The.
Hi.
I was loud?
No, not at all. No.
Okay.
Okay. Everybody else saw me, so I figured I would just let you see.
Okay.
What I was looking at.
So, we got 1266 years later, the descendants of the Hyksos. Now, this is a claim, let me make that statement, that this is a claim that LIU is making based off of the research of the Honorable Dr. Chancellor Williams. Okay? Who the Hyksos are is heavily, heavily disputed. Obviously. Because they're the foreign rulers. So if we define who are the foreign people, then we can define who is the indigenous people. You know? So it's heavily disputed who the Hyksos are. Based off of the research of Dr. Chancellor Williams, we're going to make this assumption for this discussion that the descendants of the Hyksos are the Greeks. Okay?